Welcome back to Let's Learn Academy. I'm Ashika Panikkar and today we shall be studying our social lesson, Forest and Wildlife Resources. In this lesson, we shall be studying about different animals and also about the forests. We shall begin with flora and fauna. Flora means all the plants and flower species, while fauna means all the animal species. Here you may find some facts about flora and fauna. Next, we shall study about biodiversity. Biodiversity means biological diversity. Biodiversity or biological diversity is immensely rich in wildlife and cultivated species, diverse in form and function but closely integrated in a system through multiple network of interdependencies. इसका मतलब क्या होता है? Biodiversity का मतलब होता है biological diversity, यानी biology में जितनी भी diversities, plant species, animal species हम देखते हैं, उन सब का combination. ये सारे species एक दूसरे से interrelated होते हैं, एक close network बनाते हैं and that is biodiversity. The different categories of existing plants and animal species. Based on the International Union for Conservation of Nature and Natural Resources, that is IUCN, we classify as follows. Normal species, species whose population levels are considered to be normal for their survival, such as cattle, sal, pine, rodents, etc. yani ki jo normal animals hum dekhte hain hamare around, all those are included in normal species. Endangered species, these are the species which are in the danger of extinction, yani ki near future mein wo extinct ho sakti hai. The survival of such species is difficult if the negative factors that have led to decline in their population continue to operate. The examples of such species are black buck, crocodile, Indian wild lass, Indian rhino, lion-tailed macaque, sangay, brow antler deer in Manipur, etc. Next is vulnerable species. These are the species whose population has declined to levels from where it is likely to move into an endangered category, means it is below the endangered category. In the near future, if the negative factors continue to operate, the examples of such species are blue sheep, Asiatic elephant, gangetic dolphin, etc. Rare species. Species with small population may move into the endangered or vulnerable category if the negative factors affecting them continue to operate. The examples of such species are the Himalayan brown bear, wild Asiatic buffalo, desert fox and hornbill, etc. These animals are rarely found in the near environment. Endemic species. These are species which are only found in some particular areas, usually isolated by natural or geographical barriers. Example of such species are Andaman teal, Nicobar pigeon, Andaman wild pig, Mithun in Arunachal Pradesh, etc. These animals are only found in a specific region or a specific area and is not found all around the world or all around the country. Next, and one of the important species category is extinct species. These are species which are not found after the search of known or likely areas where they may occur. A species may be extinct from a local area, region, country, continent or the entire earth. Example of such species are the Asiatic cheetah, pink head duck and dinosaurs, of course. Next topic is conservation of forest and wildlife in India. Conservation preserves the ecological diversity and our life support systems, water, air and soil. It also preserves the genetic diversity of plants and animals for better growth of species and breeding. Breeding means the process of having their food. For example, in agriculture, we are still dependent on traditional crop varieties. Fisheries too are heavily dependent on the maintenance of aquatic biodiversity. So conservation is something by which you can save your earth and also save the ecological diversity, which will ultimately help our lives. Project Tiger. Tiger is one of the key wildlife species in the faunal web. Faunal web means amongst the fauna. In 1973, the authorities realized that the tiger population had dwindled. Dwindled means decreased to 1827 from an estimated 55,000 at the turn of the century. The major threats to tiger populations are numerous, such as poaching for trade, shrinking habitat, depletion of prey-based species, growing human populations, etc. The trade of tiger skin and the use of their bones in traditional medicines, especially in the Asian countries, left the tiger population on the verge of extinction. Since India and Nepal provide habitat to about two-thirds of the surviving tiger population in the world, these two nations become prime targets for poaching and illegal trading. Our next topic is types and distribution of forests. And there are three kinds of forest. First is reserved forest. More than half of the total forest land has been declared reserved forest. Reserved forests are regarded as the most valuable because it is taken care of by the government as far as the conservation of forest and wildlife resources are concerned. Protected forest. Almost one-third of the total forest area is protected forest, as declared by the Forest Department. This forest land are protected from any further depletion. So, trees are not allowed to cut from those kind of forests, and mainly the Forest Department takes care of those kind of forests. Third one is unclassed forest. These are other forests and wastelands belonging to both government and private individuals or communities. So these are the common forests which we find around. Here we finish with our lesson. See you in the next video.